So basically here we want to develop the surface of a given solid. Now to develop the surface means if we are given a particular solid, let's say if it is a cylinder, right? And if we want to develop the surface of this solid, what we need to do is we have to just imagine that we are cutting this cylinder along any one generator. So let's say in this case we are cutting it along this generator here, and then we are opening that surface. So after cutting this cylinder, whatever surface will remain over there, that we will open and we will draw it. So that is nothing but development of surface. So in case of cylinder, now we are assuming that we are developing only lateral surface. That means we are not considering the top and bottom face. We'll only consider the lateral surface of this given solid. In case of cylinder, now if we imagine, what will be the development of this? So let's try to understand it by a model. So this is the given cylinder. As I told you that we are only considering lateral surface, so we are avoiding the top and bottom face. So let's say this is the given cylinder. Now what we'll do is we will first draw generators on the cylinder. So here I have already drawn some generators. You can see this is generator B, this is C, this is D, E, and so on. And the generator A is over here. Okay, so this is generator A, which is covered under this masking tab, right? This is generator A. Now, if we want to develop the surface of this cylinder, what we need to do is we have to just cut the cylinder along any one generator. So here we will cut the cylinder along the generator A. So we can divide this length into the equal parts by the method of inclined line, and that would give us the generators over here, right? And that would be okay. Now what should be the notation over here? So as we are cutting the cylinder along generator A, you can see here, as we are cutting it along A, the first generator is A, then it is B, C, D, and so on. And also one thing to note over here is the last generator would again be A. Why? Because that is the generator where we cut, right? So initially this is A, initially this is A, now we are opening it. So first generator is also A and the last generator is also A. So here also, if we want to give the notations, we will use capital letters over here, and this would be A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and the last would be A again, right? Yes, so this is what developed. Now what is the application of this development of surface? So the application is, let's say I want to make some solid using a sheet metal. There are many things which we use made by sheet metal. So if suppose I want to make something using sheet metal, I have to first draw it on a sheet metal, and then I will cut the shape, and then I will fold it. That is how the parts are made using sheet metal. So if I want to, let's say, make a cylinder, I have a sheet metal. Let's say this is a sheet metal. I want to make a cylinder out of it. So how to make it? So I have to first draw the developed surface on the sheet metal according to the required dimensions, and then I will fold it, and then maybe it will be welded or riveted or whatever. Alright, so that way the part will be made. So that is the application of development of surface. One of the application of development of surface. Another application is that if you want to cut so many shapes from a sheet. So let's say I have a sheet metal here and I want to make so many parts out of it. So I need to plan the layout to minimize the waste of the sheet. So for that, again, we can use this development of surface, because now we know that this would be the shape required to be cut to make the required part. We would be knowing the dimensions. So we can plan it. Like, suppose this is a big sheet and I want to make many cylinders out of it. So I have to cut different rectangles on it. So now how to cut it, from where to cut it, so that the wastage of the sheet metal would be minimum. So for that, I need to plan it like this. So I can cut it like this. So if I know the shape and size of this surface, developed surface, then it is easier to plan it. This is also one application of development of surfaces.